everyone, and welcome to my first ever Planet Zoo live stream with the creative name of Cocker Zoo. I'm assuming you guys probably get the joke by now. It's an Australian zoo, which is a joke of the word cockatoo and zoo. Don't laugh at me for that. All others were taken. Like didgeridoo, taken, kangaroo. That was going to be a series, but then what's this? Another let's play YouTuber, kangaroo. Right then, I'm going to have to name myself it a bird that isn't even in the game. I hope there are cockatoos in the game. Hi. Also, owner, your requested video is coming soon. It's coming soon. Okay, owner. Owner's a bit obsessed with learning about my name. He knows my real name now. Just go to my older videos. This is actually kind of cool. But we're gonna start Cockazoo without just this. What we're gonna start with is I know what you mean, Ona, but that's not what that word means. I think you mean videos. Yeah, well, it used to be a vlogging channel. Like what? Move over, A for Adley. A for Ashton. 3 years ago. When this Adley character was a baby. You expect me to know a lot about a children's educational vlogging channel? No, ask my 4-year-old sister. I'm not telling you the name of. Fine, there's a video I made a very long time ago with a name in it. Bridge Domino literally. You're playing because this looks like a trailer that is... No, it's not a trailer. We're getting into it. And as you can see, I didn't put the G on the end of getting, because I'm a cool boy. Okay. Wooden walls. Check. So I was looking on a website when I didn't have any live stream ideas, and it said do's and don'ts, and most of it was like cool do's. The don'ts were kind of normal, like. Okay, we can do a Roblox stream featuring Owner.
If that'll make him happy while he's waiting for my request to be finished.
Super Mimus comes in with a cute little cat in a box. No, we don't have those species in the game, I'm sorry. so much stuff you can choose. I put like, if you don't want to go through all decorating, you want to use all the new modern stuff. You've eaten a few benches. They have to be DLC bins. But why is there I in your profile? He's a scary Saurus Rex. That's why he's got an I in his profile picture on that. Yeah, we all have eyes. I mean, to be fair, if someone who watches my channel doesn't have eyes, then just then there's nothing that you can really watch on here. I guess you could hear roaring and violent sounds. Here you have coffee. Wow, Rona, those were quick comments. I was talking Turkish. There you go. Also, congrats on talking. Members of my audience that speak a different language, that's cool. I think I can speak. I can speak three different languages. Quite good. I can speak Mandarin, French, and Spanish. So, bonjour, how amigo. That is all that mixed together to say hello, good friend. And the order it goes in is why is it right silly in your name? Does it, do you mistakes a lot and be a banana? He makes memes too. That's cool then. There's like the entrance. We're gonna put a big thing on the top. Do you want my plans off at the top? So we're gonna have pitched rows. They go up and down and up and down and up and down. There you go, silly Super Mimus. Because my channel is funny themed. It's snowing in my country. It's the start of December in my country. Oh, Great Britain is the best. I actually disagree. I'd rather live in America. Actually, I wouldn't because Italy. Ah, fellow European. Hey guys, do you want me to let you in a little secret?
There's a DLC to this game coming on the 8th.
That's also a little bit of a cheeky sneak peek at what our saltwater crocodile pen's going to be all about. Here's a clue, it's going to be called Crocodive Lagoon. Finally settled on it, I've talked to some famous Planet Zoo YouTubers, see what they think of the name. Yes, you are. I think Gates of Fusion is too, because his profile picture is the turkey flag. Here you go. Go into this nice one. Is this life? Yay! Yes, it is. Anne. Yes, it is Anne. I'm Australian. This zoo's Australian as well. See if you can find a joke in the name. Watching earlier in the live stream is cheating, AN. Yeah, I am British. Just a matter of time. Boy, Ian seems like a cool guy. Ian's a cool guy. I saw some of my friends painting him. I have Matt, even if it's... Aw, you're an hour ahead of me, silly hunter. Also, Ian, you seem like a cool guy. I saw my friends, painting you as this big, mean, evil man, and I don't see why. You actually seem like a cool person to talk to on a stream. Gigantosaurus Lord of Turkey. I'm the main animator for Velociraptor movies in Britain. Nice to meet you, Gigantosaurus Lord of Turkey. Obviously, you're higher power than me. Here you go, Oceania, which is just Australia in this game. There's no such thing as... So my plan is, we're going to go from normal to Australia real fast. Yeah, this looks normal. Not till we see a giant didgeridoo sticking out with a cockatoo laying on it. Whatever it's called, like. You know when it's like stepping on it, where it's like its feet are wrapped around it. You know when birds do that. Yeah. Luckily, they've supplied us with these shapes. Use this game to educate your younger siblings. You know what shapes are. This is called a cylinder. This is basically what a circular prism would look like. If my sister ever asked me why there's not a circular prism, last time I said this to someone, they called me the naughty, naughty, no-no word. Better luck next time, then. I had tomato soup with bread. I know I'm not going to be bothered to colour the whole thing didgeridoo colour. Might as well just give up. But I won't. you went to Turkey? No, I went... I think the furthest I've ever went in the world was Egypt. I went to Hurghada to look at some dolphins and stuff like that. It was fun. I highly recommend the place I went to. I went to this nice little holiday park. Fun little holiday park. Called Serenity Fun City. Highly recommend it. It's an absolutely legendary place. I recommend going there. This video is not sponsored by them. A 260 sub 10-year-old, almost 11-year-old kid. I'm not breaking the law. My dad owns this account too. Same as the pet channel, but my dad has more ownership of the pet channel than me. I'm just going to say that because the whole East Coast Bully idea thing, because that's the name of the website he made about dogs. So I thought, oh, you should have an official YouTube channel for it. Obviously, I don't talk like that. It's more like, oh, you should have a YouTube channel for it. But I was slightly younger. But in my younger videos, I'm like, hello, my name is...
Insert full name here.
Today we'll be playing Fortnite. I used to play Fortnite, but I don't anymore. I'm technically still a good boy, aren't I?
Yes.
I'm innocent. I went to British in a dinosaur costume. I attacked the guards and then met the Queen Dinocopter and let the Queen pet the... What a wonderful story. What a nice story. I think you should apologise to the guards though. They didn't do anything to deserve being eaten by the Gigantosaurus. I don't think they did anything to deserve that. I just spent 5 minutes looking for a suitable egg for the cockatoo. They screamed at me. Totally understandable. I used to go to London a lot when I was little. Probably could have met you. $5,000. Yeah, dollars are worth way more here. Like, what exactly do you think? What is $200? That sounds so big and expensive, doesn't it? No, not really. £164 for me. I mean, yeah, we're basically billionaires. Look up the price for what yen is worth in a pound, and we're billionaires. That also reminds me of the time I managed to easily get out of an early morning work activity when I was little, because we were saying. So, what was I was at school, we had like these. Like one of those like things we do when we get to school. One of the questions was something along the lines of, when you're a billionaire, does that mean you have billion money or what? Something like along those lines. And I said, what else could it be? Elephants? Favourite part is that's what my absolute legend of a teacher back then used to say all the time to us. So, this is my cockatoo. It looks a bit funny. just a stare over the people. Just stare over those people and smile. Something sad happened yesterday. My dog died in the nether in Minecraft. I feel so... Luckily my dogs never die. Mostly because I don't really get dogs in Minecraft. I normally just sit down and use the mods I learned on Tinker. On Tinker.com. And in like 1 second, there's a nice little field full of cows. And then the next I'm getting beaten up by Andy and condors. Once again, this video is not sponsored by anything. If they want to, then I'm in. I speak the language of the gods. I can too. I mean, being able to make fart sounds with only your lips, then that's technically a...
Yay!
I had to stand up to the microphone to say that. I don't want to stand up. I probably wasted all my leg energy, so I can't walk anywhere in school tomorrow. Use spoken. No, you just said it. You just said an... We all know the point of it is you're not supposed to understand what you're saying. It's like those British rappers that were everywhere on the internet in like late 2016 to early 2017. Like BGM and stuff like that. You're saying something about my cockatoo being very nice, especially the part with the cockatoo just watching over us. Well, that was a big one. That was a giant. There actually used to be a cockatoo at like a petting zoo that I used to go to when I was little. I liked talking to it. And then there was this really old parrot next to it. It was really cool. And it could talk. I think this might be a dream, but I'm 50% sure this was a dream, but I'm pretty sure there was a time that toy had to say a naughty word. It's obviously a dream, because in that place, it was 2 years ago. That place was 2 years ago. I knew better than to teach parrots naughty words. There you go. That is the cockatoo of nothing. You can watch over the guests arriving at the zoo. Now we have to build staff buildings and get ready for the anteater habitat. We cannot do clickbait on this place. This place is clickbait free. I just remembered like 10 minutes ago about the do's and don'ts of live streaming. I'm going to turn the fan on. Computer feels a bit hot. The last thing I want is it crashing before I can build an anteater habitat and I have to stop crying for clickbait. And with the do's and don'ts thing, one part of it said that don't act worried, but you're, your zoo, your live stream might crash and you might lose internet. And in my mind I was screaming, so I'm scared because Yep. Sandbox mode. Say hello, Mrs. There you go, now we don't even have to. These are lucky four. You want to do a freezer where you just build whatever you want, use those. The worst part about the new thing is I want to add animal talk to this new staff for that. Even more for my staff room. As you all know, if you saw my last Planet Zoo series, I'm not a very big fan of building. I'm not a big fan of building, covers for them. I mean, I don't want them looking ugly, but I'm just incapable of doing it. I'm capable of building an actual good thing. So if you saw the last one, I literally just buried it in a cave. We'll do that this time, but we're going to make it a nice cave. For the water DLC, it's going to have a bit in that too. And start a bit of it off. The only problem I have with the game is that you have to implement the staff stuff, and they're just like, so you might not be the best at that. Good luck with that. They just run off. I only complain about the game. Also, that if you play it too long and you click on a bit of the mouse for too long, it will just turn super slow moving, unusably slow. If I could, I'd get a video up of it, and I'd also make an intro for this, but I thought, it's not. Also, if you guys are wondering if the
Honey Sander, the only thing is they were like part of legendary animals.
Slow open. Yeah, it is, I just haven't gone around to making a video on it in a long time. So, that's all I wanted to say. I haven't gotten around to doing it. As I said, we're going to make this a nice cave. I don't understand the language of the gods. Is this a little sneak peek? Is this a little sneak peek of having the first time in history someone called me a god? Was I? What do you think of this? I think it looks pretty nice. I now have nowhere Space Kid or Luke is just gonna pop up and either say their introduction to live stream catchphrases, which is just yo what's up, or Space Kid, which is hi this is amazing. I think my favourite one was when I was doing a premiere and Space Kid had to leave the premiere for a bit. And then she came back typing the lyrics of a song. That was a good moment. That is in my history of favourite YouTube moments. Cameo Kid returned to my premiere singing the song. I'm not saying that's a bad thing. like it. My fan base like other things. Other than my animations on them. On them stick nodes. Which I'm trying my best not to rely on tweening for. I'm getting better, apparently. I'm apparently getting better, according to some of you absolute legends. No, go, it's been 6 years and I've never been called a legend, so I'm just going to do it for you. I got told that I deserved more subs 2 times before I got called being a legend, which is never. I mean, I've said I deserve more subs before, someone said to me. Yeah. And guess what? It's not a bad thing. I'm probably not a legend. I just sit down making game videos. I used to make Fortnite videos. But yeah, I called you guys legends. Because, remember, you are perfect people. Do not change anything about you. Someone who watches my animations or anything like that, even just anyone, don't change anything about yourself, you wonderful people. Except I will say to a certain doodle bob doodle, if you don't like my content, don't watch it. Saying this to a certain person who goes by the name of Doodlebop Doodle, please don't send hate, I'm sure he's a cool person. After all, he has a SpongeBob reference in his name. Yeah, here you go. Tweety! How you doing, buddy? Thing's finished, we've got a nice little cave that it's gonna be. What would I even put in here anyway? This is gonna have Owner and Tweety shouting at each other about spamming again, isn't it? Right, I'll allow it. Isn't that my... chicken. It's not a chicken. What do you mean by chicken? One-sided fence, because anteaters don't really like me in the game. There's 3 levels in this game. Shy, do not let anyone see them. For confident, do whatever you want. For neutral, just use these fences for the best. I'm sure that'll be okay if you use like see-through things. As long as you put a few do not disturb signs. Way too small. Anteaters need something like, they need tons of square meters. Tons of square meters of playing area. Let's hire some people. Hello Jeffrey, you're the first person I'll do. Let's also be on the lookout for actual people who aren't staff. As you all know, staff aren't people. Oh, but in this game they're just models that go around and be good people. Remember in a video game I used to resort to firing people in like Zoo Tycoon games. To get more money, I'd feel really bad. To fire them. I know there's like something where it's like, we don't have enough money, your service is no longer required, thank you very much. But then, I'd pretend they did something really bad. Listen here, you. What are you talking about? And I think Tracy's trying to say I keep care of his pets. Take care of his pets. He's saying I take care of his pets, which... How do I? What exactly do I do? And let's meet new members of the first people in Cocker Zoo. First member of the zoo is Patricia. Patricia is the first member of our zoo. Oh, look at those adorable little anchorfish. You saw me calling them adorable little anteaters, even though apparently you can, they're like walking exhibit animals, you can walk in and see them. In real life, they can actually rip you to shreds. Don't recommend that. No. I'm not paper to be put in a shredder. I'm not. I think I'd be good at keeping anteaters. Monkey. Guess what? That is for tapirs or monkeys. So yeah, monkeys. You can use monkeys in it. Grr, how dare you. How angry. You don't have to, but you need to give them all of that soil. Give them all that soil. They need it. You stole me off of Patricia. Poor Patricia's all on the road. Oh, and has to sit down and cry. Poor Patricia. So, oh yeah, I can't play her because it's very laggy. But boy, am I surprised. Giant anteater, termite mound, natural, exclusively for anteaters, only them. Oh, I'm sorry. Because you have to dig. Post is here, large leaves there. They need a drink. Silly in the back. We're gonna. Now I said what we went from normal to Australia really fast. What about normal Australia to South America really fast? We make it start with temple, make it look all serious. And like. I bet I'm funner than you. Oh, Tweezy, no, say that. You will make sad. You will make Silly sad. That was very naughty. You'll make Silly very, very sad. This is a dumb shelter. It's supposed to be a dumb shelter, by the way. Don't be rude about it. Rude about it's made to be dumb. This is not South America. There's no way this is all South America back. Bamboo! You can make it look like they have like little supports and terrify all the anteaters. Probably don't know what falling part does. There you go, it looks like the walls fall down. It's like wood everywhere. You can make the scratching pole seem normal. Guys, put in the comments 0 out of 10 how fun I am at this. I won't take offence to it if you put 0, I'll just be more fun. You can make it look like the rope's gone loose up there. Definitely is an excuse that I'm just not building it properly. Look like I'm gonna put in roof trims. I'm gonna look for a really broken looking one. Give me 8 and 1 second minutes. Wow. Be over in that time. I spent over 40 minutes just building an anteater house and everything else. Here you go, a nice little broken down. How is it High Mountain Litter already? How popular are these anteaters? I've got a squeaky chair. I've had it for almost 2 years. I'm gonna put in nice little. Oh, my chair's so squeaky. My eyes! Bad thing because this game normally starts so bright that when you twist it just goes super bright like 1 minute ahead. Damage your eyes. that roof looks really good. I know, even add a bit there where it looks like the bamboo's gone all mouldy and just turned golden and slimy and fell apart. It's actually an Asian themed roof corner. Got one palm tree in it. What we've got to do? Litter. We're on it. Aren't we, guys? Everyone, put your thumbs up. Put your thumbs up if you think we're ready to tackle all of this pesky litter. Here we are. Nice little Planet Zoo music. This one's on 7 minutes. 46. Wow. 46 minutes and you guys are watching 7 minutes of it. It's actually really good. I'm actually not joking, that's actually kinda good. I'm not gonna turn into Lewis Clark, okay? Like, what do you mean you're 1 second off the end of the video? I swear I'm gonna find a way to live in you. I know what you guys are probably thinking, but Lewis Clark actually isn't that bad. Sure, he makes pretty clickbait-ish ghost exploring videos, but I think if Lewis is actually watching this video somehow, you're actually on the road to a good channel. I think is maybe just only add that warning at the start of the video if you really need it. And some other little things. Like the whole 1 minute off, how dare you? And you've actually got yourself a successful channel. Yeah, I know you can do it. See how much they're wearing much of Ozzy already. So, almost an hour in and this one. Like, Tyranny is playing soccer. I just made a good idea. I would move them, but shh, they're asleep. Patricia's asleep. Patricia's asleep. You don't want to wake her up. I just realised that their feet look like human feet. I'm scared now. Oh yeah, that's probably a joke, because I once jokingly said that I was scared if frogs actually ran instead of jumped. Seriously, what if you're in a wetland and all of a sudden you hear and you turn around and there's a big frog coming after you? That's what basilisks are for. There's like this tree up here, like, are you okay? Okay. I think you might have the sticking me inside of a plastic didgeridoo disease. I love sticking trees in Okay. Okay, appropriate tree too. You can do it. You can do it. Oh, we're starting going down. Yeah. 50 minutes in and look what we've done. Let's just lay down the plants and get it over with, and I can do the finishing touches to Owner's big special requested video. We can see if we can get some soccer anteaters. See if we can get some anteaters playing soccer the next episode. Grassland. Not really a way to get into the grassland in the grassland thing in South America without you've got all this stuff. Tundra? Yeah, okay. There's not even monkey puzzles. You have to look very closely because you can. There's no way there's caribou moss. So you do. Common reeds, grassland. What? Aquatic. Back. You were at the end. Sorry, I had to tell you this, but we're at the end of the video. I'm just going to give the anteaters a few plants and add them a big ombu tree. And that's it. Welcome back. That's kind. Okay then. There you go, a nice little pull, and we're done. So I hope you enjoyed today's video, and be sure to like and subscribe and share this video, and I'll see you later. Bye bye.